got to go really quick here. We hope you enjoyed that interview with Dave Yeager, and thanks to Grant and Doug for letting us borrow that. Sean Salisbury coming up in just a few minutes, but we're coming back when we should be breaking. So we're going to fly through four down territory here, brought to you by Fire Wings. 21 different flavors to choose from. Firewings.com, just wing it. Kyle Madsen, question
Give one. The 49ers an early Christmas present.
I'm going to give them a healthy knee for Jimmy Garoppolo. I mean, really, isn't that what it comes down to? I'm giving them a healthy Jimmy Garoppolo who is 100% when he comes back to training camp. I was reading last night about their core. They have a good young core to build around with a number of guys from DeForest Buckner to Dante Pettis to George Kittle to Matt Breida. You need a healthy Jimmy Garoppolo. I can't think of anything better to give them.
Assuming that Garoppolo is going to come back healthy anyways, I'm giving them an edge rusher. I don't think Nick Bosa is a possibility, so I'm giving them Josh Allen from Kentucky. I think he's a game-changing player that would turn their defense around.
Tough to fit him in a package. Number two.
Second down.
Same thing, but give the Raiders an early Christmas present.
I'm going to give them a place to play and some stability for next year. I'm going to give them an early decision on that so nobody has to worry about it, so fans understand what they're going through. And that's not just a Christmas present to the Raiders. For me, that's more about a Christmas present to Raider fans. They deserve to at least have that much stability in what will be their final year, hopefully being able to watch their team in the Bay Area.
I'm giving them a do-over on the Khalil Mack trade. They can take it all back.
That's
they could use it.
That's better than mine. Third down.
What's your game of the weekend?
Game of the weekend. Man, there are a few decent ones as we head down the road to the finale of this season. And by the way, when I say there's a few, I'm lying. There really aren't. There are two I can look for. I'll pick one. Kyle, you'll probably pick the other. So I'm going to go Texans-Eagles because I figured you'd pick the other one. Philadelphia hosting Houston, the defending Super Bowl champions at home with BD and Nick Foles with their playoff hopes just clinging by a thread.
Yeah, the one I'm really looking forward to is actually tomorrow, Ravens at Chargers.
Oh, you fooled me.
Very much looking forward to. I want to see what the Chargers offense can do against that very good Ravens defense. And the Ravens fighting for a playoff spot. They need this win. The Chargers have clinched already. It's going to be very interesting down in L.A.
Okay, I will fully accept that. I thought you were going to go Steelers-Saints, so I avoided that. So I'm switching mine because I think Steelers-Saints to me, that's a huge game. Three big games at least over the weekend. Fourth down.
What game makes you want to poke your eyes out this weekend?
Gosh, there's a few. There's a lot of crap games this weekend. Probably, I don't know, Falcons-Panthers.
Oh, hey, Chiefs-Seahawks is going to be a good game,
too. Oh, my God, I completely missed Chiefs-Seahawks. You're right. As a matter of fact, that is the game of the weekend. Redskins-Titans. Last weekend, we had a ton of really good matchups this weekend. Bengals-Browns, Buccaneers-Cowboys, Vikings-Lions, Giants-Colts. There's a lot of bad games.
Okay, here's all those games you just mentioned at least have some sort of like playoff.
Even
Jaguars at Dolphins, like the Dolphins are trying to stay alive in the playoff race. The game that really makes me want to gouge my eyes out is Broncos at Raiders. I know it's Monday night. I know it's the last game at the Coliseum, but there's nothing to play for in that game. It's an AFC West matchup, but it's two teams going the wrong direction late in the year. I'm out, dude.
Well, that's one of those reasons, Kyle, why there's a difference between somebody who watches the NFL and somebody that played in the NFL. When you say there's nothing to play for, I say there's everything to play for. There's pride. And pride, in some cases, is more important than a playoff spot.
I'll listen to that game on Sports 1140.
Okay. Well, then,
but I'm not going to watch it.
You know? Okay, that's forgiven. Like you're going to watch the Dolphins game. like you're going to watch the Skins
my
and
girlfriend
Titans.
Is a big Dolphins fan.
Oh, is
so.
She? So is Hootie from Hootie and the Blowfish, Darius Rucker.
His name's Darius Rucker.
We'll take a break. Sean Salisbury will join us next in his final appearance before Christmas. We'll talk to him in a couple minutes. Sports 1140 KHDK.
This is Kyle Madsen with your top stories on Sports 1140. The Kings are back in action tonight at home against the Memphis Grizzlies. Our coverage on Sports 1140 begins with game night at 5:30. Then Kings Live is at 6:30, and tip-off with the G-Man is slated for 7 o'clock. And speaking of the Kings, Buddy Hield had a birthday on Monday, and it turns out he turned 26, not 25. Hield told Grant and Doug before Monday's game that there was a mistake on virtually every site that said his birthday was in 1993, when his passport and driver's license all said 1992. So a happy belated 26th birthday to Buddy Hield. It's 7:34. Peak Financial wants to talk retirement. Dial #250. That's #250 and say the word money. Those are your top stories. Now back to the drive on Sports 1140 KHDK.
Hey, Sean Salisbury is ready to go. Have him on in just a second. Yeah, I'm wearing a Santa hat. Kyle's wearing a Santa hat, which is funny. It's like, do we ever wear those and think, like, I wonder if people are going to think I'm Santa? You know, like, everyone knows you're not Santa. I guess it's like wearing a hat of your favorite team, really. It's like wearing a Giants hat or whatever. It's a ball cap. It's appropriate. But I will tell you, man, I forget every year when I wear one of these suckers. Santa's got to be a hot, stinky, BO-smelling mess. When it's all said and done, this thing is hot. Now, granted, he's in a sleigh, high in the air, and it's wintertime. So I understand that, but can you imagine going from freezing cold and wind chill to going down a chimney into a warm house and then back? Like, the temperature differential alone has got to give you... I think what we don't see is on the 26th and 27th and 28th, that's what we need a movie on. What is Santa like in the days after Christmas? He's got to be a mess. Just a hot, fat mess. Speaking of hot, Sean Salisbury and Dave Richard coming up at 8:05, brought to you by Fire Wings. 21 different flavors to choose from. Firewings.com, just wing it. Also, how many cookies does he ingest? Like, does anybody leave him a... Speaking of fire, why not leave Santa a pack of breaded Malaysian curry fire wings? You think he probably gets tired of the cookies? I would think. That's a lot of sugar.
Leave him some Pepto.
Yeah, something. From the 916, I will be dressing up as Santa for the first time at school today, and I'm not looking forward to it. Very hot and an itchy beard wig. Yeah. Rich, you're absolutely right. We need a Santa Claus behind the music. The real story. Santa Claus behind the music.
There's no way he's, like, pleasant, right?
Not around now. Can you imagine the pressure?
No.
I had a paper route when I was a kid. I delivered papers for the Sacramento Bee back when, you know, back when you had 12-year-olds delivering the paper and not some, you know, 41-year-old guy named Frank in his van.
Shout out to child labor laws. Very cool.
Yeah, I was 12 years old. It was the first real job I could have.
That's back when they had the manual printing press.
Probably, yeah. They just peeled it off the caves.
Yeah.
So every morning at about 3 a.m., the big bee truck would pull up to my driveway and drop off these stacks of unfolded papers. I would have to get up at 3:30, and then you had a big bag of rubber bands, and I would sit on the steps, and I would listen to, I had a little tiny stereo or radio that my parents got. Ooh, Dave got his, I get it. And I would play such songs as NXS, Kick. I would play OMD, what's that song? Was it Don't Leave?
Do You Believe in Life After Love by Cher?
Oh, come on, what was the OMD hit? If you leave, thank you. I won my first ever radio contest on the former FM 102, and I won tickets to go see Tony the Tiger Lopez versus John Molina. Hey, being up that early has its perks. So I would fold all these papers and put them in a pile, and then I had a bicycle, and you had these white canvas bags
mm-hmm.
that would hang over the back of your seat, and would constantly get tangled up in your spokes. And I would stuff the papers in each side until they were just bursting right down my parents' driveway and then immediately up this giant hill at the end of my street. And I would start my paper out. It would take a couple hours. First off, my legs were like remember in Family Guy when Stewie got addicted to steroids? Like, that's what my legs were like. But the fun part would be throwing the papers. But I would, like, if I would miss, I wouldn't go back. I just, you know, screw it, right?
Yeah, of course.
But the idea was, and I don't, you're probably too old to remember the video game Paperboy.
Oh, I played so much Paperboy growing up.
Okay. So I would, that was the whole thing, was trying to get it on the old porch. A couple times I'd hit the window.
Also, Paperboy is my favorite rapper.
Is Paperboy a rapper?
Shout out Atlanta fans.
Okay. And so I can only imagine, oh, and then by the way, as if that wasn't bad enough, by the way, we're vamping because we can't find Sean right now, in case you're wondering. As if that wasn't bad enough, when it came time every month to get paid, I would have to go door to door and collect for the B subscription. And if I couldn't find, like, if somebody wasn't at the door or they didn't pay, that came out of my monthly pay. They really had a nice scam going there on kids, the papers did. But I was thankful. I got money. So I can only imagine Santa Claus is basically like the world's biggest paper boy. But instead of throwing papers, he's got to place presents under a tree. So yeah, maybe more than cookies.
You can tell that he got to my house was one of the last ones because Santa's presents were always like just right by the fireplace.
They weren't under the tree?
No, because our tree was in a separate room. And then the presents would always just be right there by the fireplace. So you could tell he got to my house last because he didn't want to walk all the way over to the tree.
That's kind of lazy.
I know.
I always knew Santa had presents specifically for me because almost every year I would get a nice pack of Fruit of the Loom underwear and my last name was already written in the waistband.
That's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Nice of the elves to do that for you.
Really was. Occasionally also on my socks. Because God forbid you lose, you know, there's a pair of underwear lying around somewhere. People are going to know whose it was by the last name on them. That made sense. Oh, what's this random piece of worn underwear doing at my house, school, place of worship? Oh, those must be Dave's. Whereas the stronger question is, I would not, if I had left underwear somewhere, I wouldn't want my last name on there.
Right, that
I
speaks volumes about you that your folks were like, we should write his name on these.
My name was written.
Sorry, that's Santa.
Thank you. Well, I think Santa and my folks got together on that, to be fair.
Oh, okay, that's fair.
I my mother writes our last name on, my mother writes, this isn't a joke, I'll send you a picture during the break. I have casserole pans that my mom has given me with her last name on the bottom. Not where you cook, but when you turn over the pan.
Yeah. Is that in case she leaves it at somebody's house?
That's what she says. But it's like, at some point, cut your losses. If you want the pan bad enough, don't forget it.
Right, exactly.
And if you do, guess what?
You lost the pan. Go to that person's house and you steal it.
Weird thing is, not a shortage on casserole pans in the world. It's not like that's the one you've been allotted for life.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
Were your stocking stuffers wrapped individually?
Yes and no. I had some that were wrapped individually, and then, like, the candy and stuff, you know, the little things were not. Like, if I had, like, a squirt gun or a flamethrower or something, you know, the Hasbro flamethrower for kids, I would have that in there.
Lawn darts.
Yeah, exactly. Croquet set. Were yours?
No. Our stuff is always just kind of stuffed in the stocking. But I know people who wrap all their stocking stuffers are like wrapped in like tissue paper.
Wow.
Or wrapping paper or whatever. And that just seems like a huge hassle.
Yeah, I don't know how we do it at our house. Melissa handles that. And then I stuff a couple things in her stocking. As you know, she's the head of the stockings.
Right.
The best present I ever got I think as a kid, regardless of the present, one of the best things you can do for little kids is at some point in their life, if not every year, but at least a couple times, get them a giant box, something that's in a giant box, so they can have like the big package. And they spend all the time leading up to Christmas wondering what is in this giant pack that has their name on it. And one year, I had a huge package. I'm trying to get through this, dude, because you're staring at me. And I spent weeks wondering what it was.
You spent weeks wondering what your huge package was.
Right. And finally, when I opened it on Christmas Day, it was a VCR and handheld camcorder set.
Oh, snap.
On the box.
Oh, no.
So it was unfortunate because here's what happened. What my parents actually got me was a TRS-80 computer. Old people will remember from Radio Shack. It was awesome.
Wait, from where?
From Radio Shack, yeah. From a company called Tandy, which I don't think is around anymore. A TRS-80 or a Trash 80, as some people would call them. This was a computer that you had to hook up to your actual television, to the back of the TV, via those little, there used to be attachments with little claws on the end, and you would hook them up to these screws on the back of your TV, because there was no HDMI, there wasn't even any RGB cords. You literally hooked up your Atari or your Intellivision or your TRS-80 to your TV. So that was an amazing present, but the problem was that when I opened the wrapping and saw the box, I thought I was getting a camcorder and VCR, and so I started thinking about like all the awesome movies I was going to make and tape and watch. By the time I got to the computer, which any year would have been the most amazing present possible and still was, I did everything I could to not feign disappointment that it wasn't a TV and a VCR, and that should be a lesson to everybody. Don't ever wrap other presents in boxes that may not contain those, where the present might be, the box might be a better present. But now I know where things have gone, because do you know, I asked for one thing this year, Kyle. My wife does this with me every year. What do you want for Christmas? I buy stuff for myself year round. I don't buy me anything. She always has to. I asked for one thing this year. And I didn't even realize it when I was doing it.
Is it appropriate to say on air?
Oh, sure it is. And my wife texted me at one point. She goes, "You realize you're old and weird." I asked for an Instant Pot. That's all I asked for. Those pressure cookers.
Yeah, of course.
That's what I asked for Christmas. That's all I
asked. That's fair. That's totally fair.
Kind of. And come on, how lame of a gift is that to ask? That's not fun. I'm not going to roll around on the floor with my Instant Pot and laugh and...
You can.
Hang out with friends and be like, "Are you bringing the Instant Pot?"
You can with imagination.
What was the best gift you ever got?
Ooh.
Or worst gift you ever got?
The best gift I ever got.
Yeah.
Oh, man. It was probably the new computer I got a couple years ago. I was in the market for a new computer, and my folks took it upon themselves to get me one that was one I was never going to afford in 100 years.
Sure.
Is that Christmas.
The laptop you've got right now?
Yeah, it sure
wow.
is. And that was very nice, because it's made my life way easier. So that's probably up there. When I was a kid, though, my mom worked at Sony, and I got a PlayStation the year they came out.
Really, video game systems might be the great all-time Christmas. Yeah. Because you hook them up. Just, you're in your PJs.
Yeah. Played it just ad nauseum.
That PlayStation sound comes on.
Well, and the PlayStation was where Final Fantasy VII on PS1 was where my brother and I really started bonding. He's 7 years older than I am, so we didn't really ever have anything in common.
Right.
He was not big into sports. I was... and video games, though, we would just sit there and play Tony Hawk or, like I said, Final Fantasy VII, just for hours during the summers.
Sure. Does that ring a bell? That's your open. That's your PlayStation 1 turn-on sound. When you would open your PlayStation 1, that's what would play. Would be the, and this was the greatest sound to me. Especially when the little ding-ding-dings hit. Right
and then
here.
The PlayStation logo popped up.
Maybe the greatest activation of a video game sound there is.
What is your Mount Rushmore of activation of video games?
It wasn't the PlayStation 2. PlayStation 2 was like, bah! Tell you the worst gift I ever gave that still is an issue in my household to this day is a fight between myself and my wife was the second gift, second Christmas we ever had together. When I met my wife, she was living in, she was roommates with another couple. And my wife was not domestic, quote unquote, at all.
She was like not house trained?
At all. There's still a picture we have to this day, which is a joke picture, but it's true. It's a picture I took of her when she was making one of those Chinese food out of the bag, the frozen thing. You just pour it all in a pot and stir it.
Sure.
And I took a picture, and she's smiling with the wooden spoon in her hand because it was so insane. Oh, my God, Melissa's in the kitchen. I did all the cooking. I did all that because I knew how to cook. She did not know how to cook.
Sure.
So we were not living together yet. And I got her for Christmas, amongst other things, I got her a crock pot. Because here's the thing, whether it's a starting family, if your child's going off to college, probably the best thing you can get them is a rice cooker. But a crock pot's right there because you don't know have to know how to cook. Chop up some potatoes, chop up some carrots, chop up some celery, put in a pack of gravy mix with water and whatever meat you're putting in there, and boom, when you get home, it's done. It does everything for you. And she was so pissed. Like, oh, you're trying to get me in the kitchen? I'm like, no, dude, I'm trying to help you not eat Taco Bell every night or whatever other assorted fast food you're using. Not that there's anything wrong with fast food. She's still pissed to this day. Whenever it comes up, Dave got me a crock pot once. I'm like, I almost said a bad word. I'm like, bro, I just asked for an Instant Pot. It's not, you get somebody a vacuum or an iron.
An apron.
But yet, here's what's funny. The older I've gotten, if I got like one of those badass Dyson vacuums or a Roomba, if I got an apron that had a King's logo on it, I'm stoked.
Right. I
love it.
I'm at the point where I'm like, hey, get me stuff I need because I pay for like food and rent.
Right. So give like me something I can use.
Yeah, I'm in.
Hello, caller. Who's this? And welcome into the drive. Merry early Christmas.
Hello, caller. Hello, Dave.
Hello.
Hello, Kyle.
Hi.
Hey.
First day of winter, Dave.
Thank you.
Hey. You know who it is now, Dave?
Is it Tim the Trucker?
Yes, sir. Hey. Have a wonderful Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Be safe out there. Merry, merry Christmas.
Can I have a bad Wednesday?
Hey, yeah. I mean,
have a bad Wednesday? Nah, Wednesday's okay.
Tim, you're the best. We appreciate
Love you, Tim.
That. Thank
Tim's
you,
great.
Tim. From the 916, I got my wife a waffle maker and a pan set. I use waffle maker at least twice a month. Nothing wrong with that.
I'm really excited for what I got my significant other. I don't want to say it because she listens to the show.
Okay. Give me a hint. Can we play 20 questions?
No.
Oh. Well, I'd ask you to text me, but then we're leaving out the rest of the audience. I don't want to do that. I'll be in mystery with everyone else. But you're very excited about it?
I am. It's very creative. I'm not usually creative when it comes to gifts, except for yours. I'm really excited for you to open your present.
I'm very excited about what I got both you and Eunice for Christmas. Because, you know, I'm just going to tell you. You know what it is? It's whatever the hell either of you want it to be. Because that's the
Did you go Amazon gift card
that's
again?
That's the great thing about every year. You know the drill. Every year, you get an Amazon gift card from me for Christmas and for birthday.
Hey, remember last year? You got me something different for my birthday this year.
I did?
Yeah, you got me a hack, Lids gift card.
Oh, that's, well, still a gift card.
Hey, you remember last year when you weren't going to get me a Christmas present, but then I got you a pack of lighters, so you felt the need to get me that?
I was so pissed off. Great, now I have to get Kyle.
Now this is just a thing.
Here's your gift, Kyle. It's fine. Christmas stresses me out. I feel like no matter what, there's people I didn't get gifts for. And I go through like this entire, like after the show, I'm leaving immediately. Usually I stay an hour or two after and talk to people.
Mess around.
I'm leaving immediately and I'm sneaking out the back because I am petrified that somebody's going to get me. Like one of our sales guys, I won't say who, got me a present, right? And it was a very cool present. But here's what happens. I got the present. It was really sweet and thoughtful, but it kind of pissed me off because now I have to get this person a present. And I wasn't going to. And I'm going to be petrified today because today's the day. If somebody gets me a present earlier in the week like he did or uh-huh. she, I can be like, oh, I'll see you Friday. I got yours. You're going to love it. And then I go home and stress out about what to get them. Today,
Amazon gift card.
Right, exactly. Today, if somebody gives me a gift, I don't have that excuse.
Sure.
And if I didn't get them a gift, there's nothing worse than that. They give you a gift. Hey, here you go. Thanks for everything. Merry Christmas. And you're like, oh, thanks.
No, it's not. No, see, because you don't give presents to get them back.
I understand that. It's still a horrible look.
I disagree.
I feel like the worst person in the world when that happens.
No, I disagree because if somebody springs a present on you, that you weren't expecting, you're not obligated to then reciprocate said present.
Unless that
Now, if you and, let's say you and I, let's say we do this show together for 10 years. I know. Let's say we do this show together for 10 years.
Right.
And we exchange gifts every year.
Yes.
And then just randomly on year 11, you're like, no, I'm not getting, I know I'm getting something, but I'm not getting him anything. That's a bad look. That's a tough look.
Can I just say that outside my family, the soul, I'm just going to admit this and then we got to go to break.
Yeah.
Outside of family members, the sole reason I get anybody a Christmas present and how I determine who I get a Christmas present is based entirely on whether or not I think they're going to get me a Christmas present and I don't want to feel crappy. Like if it was up to me, I wouldn't get anybody anything. I would just call it even. Like my sister and I have this deal. We would get each other gift cards every year. Now we just don't. We don't because we're just basically re-gifting the same gift card.
Sure.
I judge who I buy presents for based on the odds that they're going to get me something. But if I had my way, I'd say, just save the money. Don't worry about me. That's probably a bad way to go. 3 years ago, I got a Roomba for Christmas. I was very excited, the automatic vacuums. I was very excited until it ran over a dog turd. You ever been around a Roomba that rolled over a dog turd, Kyle?
No.
Yeah,
that sounds awful.
It's pretty much the worst thing in the entire world. It sucks it up into the vacuum itself and then just launches it everywhere like a giant turd blower. From the 916, Dave, just get everybody card saying, I saved the kings, you're welcome. We'll take a break.
You just go to the Kings game and stand up, you're like... Yeah, here.
I should just get, honestly, that's not a bad idea. Next year, I'm just going to get Christmas cards with, like, me smiling on the front, and you open it.
Golden One Center?
Right, and you just open it, and all it just says is you're welcome.
Dude, it would be so funny if you went to Golden One, put a bow on the side of it, and then took a picture of you standing outside of it.
From the 916, re-gifting a gift card is the laziest thing I've ever heard. Oh, I've got lazier things for you. We'll take a break. One time in my parents' house.
Dude.
Okay, sorry. We'll take a break. When we come back, Dave Richards next. Sports 1140 KHDK.